In this lesson, we will discuss how to use procedures within procedures. Many programs used in real-world applications are very lengthy and consist of multiple procedures, and often procedures are called within other procedures. Here's one example with a main subprocedure, two additional subprocedures, and a function procedure. After running this program, two message boxes will appear. The first message box states 1 plus 2 equals 3, and the second message box states 13, 2, high by. Let's discuss why these values appear in the message boxes. As your programs become more complicated, it's often helpful to write down the values of the variables in each procedure so you don't have to keep track of all that information in your head. In the subprocedure main, three variables are created, A, B, and C. A and B are given a double data type and initially assigned the default value of 0. C is given a string data type and the default value is null or nothing. Next, A is assigned the value 1, B is assigned the value 2, and C is assigned the character string high. Then a message box is created that displays the value of A, which is 1, plus the value of B, which is 2, equals the value of the function addyAB. We must calculate the value of addyAB before the message box can be displayed on the screen. In Addy, the variables Y and Z are automatically created and given a double data type because A and B in main are double variables. The variable A in main is linked with the variable Y in Addy, and the value of Y in Addy is initialized to 1. The variable B in main is linked to Z in Addy. The value of Z in Addy is initialized to 2. Y plus Z is calculated and assigned to Addy, so Addy now has the value 3. The function procedure Addy is terminated with the end function statement. The values of A and B in main do not change because the values of Y and Z in Addy were not updated. The value of Addy is returned to main where it is invoked, and the variables Y and Z in Addy are terminated. The message box then displays 1 plus 2 equals 3. Next, the subprocedure jumble is called. In jumble, the variables X, Y, and Z are automatically created. X and Y in jumble are given double data types because A and B in main are double variables. Z in jumble is given a string data type because C in main is a string variable. The variable A in main is linked with the variable X in jumble. If X is changed inside jumble, that will change A in main when jumble is terminated. The value of X in jumble is initialized to 1. The argument B in main is not linked with the argument Y in jumble because parentheses are placed around B. Only the value of B in main, which is 2, is passed down to Y in jumble. If Y is changed within jumble, that will not affect B in main. The variable C in main is linked with the variable Z in jumble. The value of Z in jumble is initialized to the string high. Another double variable is created in jumble named W, and it is initialized to the default value of 0. Next, the subprocedure calcW is called within jumble. Jumble halts and waits until calcW is completed before continuing on. In Calc W, the variables N1 and N2 and ANDs are automatically created and given a double data type because the arguments X, Y, and W in Jumble have a double data type. The variable X in Jumble is linked with the variable N1 in Calc W. The value of N1 in Calc W is initialized to 1. The variable Y in Jumble is linked with the variable N2 in Calc W, and the value of N2 is initialized to 2. The variable W in Jumble is linked with the variable ANDs in Calc W, so the variable ANDs is initialized to the value 0. Next, ANDs is assigned the value of N1 times N2, which is 2. The subprocedure Calc W is terminated with the end sub statement. Notice that the values of X and Y in Jumble do not change since the values of N1 and N2 in Calc W did not get updated. However, the variable W in Jumble changes to 2 because it is linked to ANDs in Calc W. Once Calc W is finished, the variables N1, N2, and ANDs are terminated. Back in Jumble, Y is assigned the value 10. Next, X in Jumble is assigned a new value, W plus the value of ADDIE XY. In ADDIE, the variables Y and Z are automatically created and given a double data type because the variables X and Y in Jumble have a double data type. The variable X in Jumble is linked with the variable Y in ADDIE, so the value of Y in ADDIE is initialized to 1. The variable Y in Jumble is linked with the variable Z in ADDIE, so the value of Z in ADDIE is initialized to 10. The value of Y plus Z is calculated and assigned to ADDIE. Remember that we're using the value of the variable Y in ADDIE to calculate ADDIE. So now ADDIE has the value of 11. The function procedure ADDIE is terminated with the end function statement. The values of X and Y in Jumble do not change because the values of Y and Z in ADDIE were not updated. Once the function procedure ADDIE is terminated, the variables Y and Z are also terminated. Back in Jumble, the value of ADDIE is inserted to the location where ADDIE is invoked. So X now has the value of W, which is 2, plus ADDIE XY, which was 11, so X equals 13. Finally, Z is assigned the current value of Z, which is the character string hi, combined with the character string bi. The subprocedure Jumble is terminated and we return to main. The value of X, Y, and Z in Jumble have all been updated. However, only A and C in main will be changed. B in main will not be updated with a new value because we passed B by value, not by reference. The value of A will be updated to the new value of X, which is 13. And the value of C in main will be updated to the new value of Z in Jumble, which is high by. Now that Jumble is finished, the variables X, Y, Z, and W in Jumble will all be terminated. Now the last message box will appear and display the values of A, B, and C in main, which are 13, 2, and high by.